Happy long fair to Breda. First day of spring. What a day to decide to bring in the most shameful carnival. Today, February 1st, is Ireland's day of shame. Today's the day the politicians dip their grubby and greedy hands into the pockets of the lowest paid workers in the land and take a euro for every hour on the clock. Now, my friend and comrades here have asked me to recite a speech by Big Jim Larkin, the founding father of organized labor, close to here almost 100 years ago, at the end of the lockout when we were down but about to rise up off our knees. Unfortunately, brothers and sisters, this speech is only too as relevant today as it was in 1913. I ask you to listen to the words carefully, steel yourself for the fight, and organize to defend your rights. Friends, comrades, citizens, brothers and sisters, the masters of industry, so-called, the captains of capital, so-called, the self-praising and self-named and self-not-effacing of anything, merchant princes no less, they said they would isolate Dublin. They said they would break the spirit of the people of Dublin. They said they would wait and watch us starve. But Dublin stood, and Dublin survived, and Dublin persevered, and Dublin said, as with Camille de Moulin, at the gate of the Bastille, on the night the peoples of the earth entered through it onto history, Dublin also said, the great are not great. The great only appear great because we are on our knees. Let us arise! So we say, as we said to our so-called masters in 1913 and 1916, we say the same to our so-called leaders now. We the Larkinites, the people of Dublin, the workers of Ireland, beware! Beware of the thing that is coming! Beware of the risen people! For we shall take what you would not give. And so, the workers of Dublin and the workers of Ireland have sent me to say unto you that ye shall crucify Christ, neighbor, in Dublin town.